This is the latest demo of Rodeo, our Uber clone by appscript.com. On the right, we have the customer app, and on the left, we have the captain app, the one which you can see here, right? So let me start by launching both apps. I launched the captain app, and I also launched the customer app. All right, so on the captain app, we have an option to register, where we'll have to fill in a certain, you know, a few details, and we have to and that will complete the registration. We can register either under an operator or we can register as an independent contractor / freelancer. Alright, and here we go with the login page. On the driver app, now we've added a feature where you can either log in with your email or phone number. You can also recover your password with your email or phone number. You will be sent a verification code to your phone number in case it's a phone number retrieval. And if it's retrieved by email, you will be sent a email to reset your password. On the customer app, similarly, we have two options. We've added the option to change the language. So in case you want to support French, German, Arabic, whatever it might be, you can simply add languages on the back office, and we've already added support for a few, and you can choose the one you want to use right now. So we've added a few here. All right. So let's start with the registration process for a customer. We've added two new features where you can register with Facebook or Google Plus, or you can do a regular registration with your phone number and email. So let me start with making a new registration. Let's take a photo, right? So let's take my photo here, right? So I use my photo and I add my name. So there we go. I add my phone number, which is 913104891. All right, that's cool. And then I add my email address. So here we go. I've added my email address. I add my password. And confirm my password. If I had a referral code, I would have, I would get a discount or some credit into my wallet. But at this moment, I don't have one. We can also view and alter the terms and conditions at any point. I can confirm my sign up by, confirming that I agree with the terms and conditions. I go to the next stage. On the next stage, I get the verification code, right? Which will be sent to my phone number. So I'll be waiting for that. Here it comes. So it's 12671. 12671. So the number would then be confirmed. So once it's confirmed, I would be, registered on the app, and I will be taken to the homepage where I can see all the available cars in my region. At this moment, we have set up these, dummy values or dummy vehicle types in our location. When I click on any car type, I will be able to see the rate card for each car type. So here we have it for cars, we have it for SUVs, right? And even the vehicles can all be configured to either support book now and book later, right? So we can change which vehicle type supports book now and which vehicle type supports book later. I will show you that. I'll make one vehicle type only work for book now and another one just to work for book later. So I will demo that shortly. Right. Let me walk you through the other cool features on the customer app which we've just added in our latest update. One is the option of marking an address as a favorite. So I can choose, I can move my map marker and I can mark this as a favorite. So I'll call this my home. And this will be saved as my favorite location. So you can see that the star is not colored. If I move to another address, it won't be colored. Now if I go back to my current, and if I move it back to the marker, I will see that, I can just go back here and choose my favorite address directly. So it's a faster way of saving addresses, right? And I can also look for an address on Google. So I can click on this and I can look for, let's say, my office. And it'll find my office and I can just select that. So this is an option we've added. I can see my profile. You can see that we've added. You can see your email number and full name. If I can change my password. This is again a new feature. And it'll send me a verification code. And once I confirm my number, that's when I can change my password. Oops, so there, I've got that option there. If I want to edit anything in my profile, I need to first confirm my password on the app. So let me confirm that. And then let me edit something in my profile. If not, it won't let me do that. So the next cool feature we've added on our app is the wallet. and I can add credit into my wallet. So let's add a card. For example, let's add the test card that we have on our app. Okay, so I add this, and once I've added my card, I can then recharge my wallet with my card. So let's say my balance is getting low and I want to recharge my wallet with, say, $400-$500. I can add the credit. I will authorize a transaction, and it'll directly bill my card with the, you know, with the required amount. So let me add that credit, confirm. Amount is added to my wallet. If I go back and check the transactions on my wallet, I will see that, you know, $499 has been added to my account. So that is the money which is being deposited into my wallet now. So my latest balance is $499. You know, if the app can run, we can run campaigns on the app to add, like, say, bonus credit to customers. This is a great way to market the app. It's almost like loyalty points. You know, people, if you want to reward your customers with loyalty points or, let's say, additional money, you can just add that directly to their wallet. So it's a very nice feature that we've added. It's commonplace in Asia. You know, a lot of companies in Asia like PQ, like Ola and like Kareem, all these companies use this feature, and we've built the feature in the exact same manner. We have the different FAQs. These can again be configured on the back office, completely managed. So you have to nothing is hard coded. You can refer a friend. This is a referral system we've added. We can refer people and share them the referral code which they can use to sign up to the app. So we have that feature added. We can see the booking history on the app, the upcoming, past, and cancelled. I will walk you through all of this shortly. I request a ride. So let's now walk you through the request a ride process. So now I've configured the car just for book now, so you only see that option at the bottom. The taxi is available for book now. The SUV is available for book now and book later. Right, so this is how you can actually configure which vehicle type is available for which type of booking directly from the back end. So now let me log into the driver app. So I log into the driver. As soon as I log in on the driver app, it will first ask me to select a vehicle which I want to log in with. So these are all the vehicles that I have, you know, added on the back end under my profile. So I can choose one of them. So let's choose the car, the Honda Accent. So now I've logged into that car. As soon as I log into the car, and if I go online, I would be visible under the car type in my customer app. So let me go to the car type. It's in the SUV. So I've logged into the, you can see that I'm now visible under the SUV category, right? So now I can see, if I go offline on the driver, I would go offline even on the customer app. If I go back online, I would come back as online on the customer app. So we refresh this every few seconds. So yeah, there we go. And if I change my pickup location, you should notice that the ETA changes at the bottom. It's changed from 1 minute to 3 minutes. Now if I come back to my location, the ETA would be updated to 1 minute, right? So this is completely in real time. So now I say a book now. Now if I add the drop, let's add the drop at the airport. So when I add a drop address, right, I would see the fare estimate at the bottom of the page, right? And it plots the path between the pick and the drop. So I see that my ride estimate is visible right here, right? Now I can change my payment method. I can choose to pay with my wallet credit. I can choose to pay with cash. I can choose to pay with card. So our app supports all three forms of booking and all three payment methods rather, which again is very similar to Kareem and to Ola in India, right? So this is a very cool feature which we've just added, and it'll work so that the app will now work for any sort of market. So let's say I want to do a card booking. Let's start with a card booking. I choose the payment method as card, and I confirm the booking. So as soon as I confirm the booking, the driver would get an alert that you can click on any part of the driver app page, and you know the booking would be accepted. So as soon as I did that, you would see that, you know, I can see where the car is. Since I'm sitting in the same address, you know, the ETA is just 1 minute. I get the photo of the driver, I get which vehicle he's driving. I can decide to cancel the booking, I can share the ETA. So let's say if I want to share the ETA, I can choose to share it by WhatsApp, or I can even share the ETA via SMS. So let's share the ETA. Let's share it to my other number. Right? So we can now, okay, I don't have it, not sending me text messages. So I can decide to contact the driver if I wish. And if I want to cancel the booking, I can just cancel it directly. And I will say, yes, I wish to cancel the booking. It'll ask me for the reasons and I change my mind and let's cancel the booking. So the booking was cancelled and the driver was informed in real time that the customer has cancelled the booking. So now I can go in and I can decide to, you know, make a new booking again. This time I'll change the payment method. I will use my wallet to pay for it. But I will show you two more features. I will show you the search pricing feature that we've just added. So now we've added a search zone on the airport. So if I go to the airport and I put that as my pickup and I click on book now, the app will tell me that this is, you know, there's a search pricing applied for airport pickups at this moment. And I can choose to accept or deny this, right? That is what I can do. So let's say I accept the search, right? Now I put the address as my home address and the app will return the, you know, the ride estimate. You would notice that the ride estimate has changed because now the search has been applied, right? So we can also decide to apply a promo code. So let's say I want to apply a promo code and apply that. It's now applied successfully. So I will now get a discount at the end of the ride because I've applied the promo code. Right? I think we've set it up for a 5%, I think it's a $5 discount rather. So let's confirm this booking. As soon as I confirm, let me choose the payment method. Let me choose wallet, right? And I confirm the booking. So the driver can decide to deny. In case the driver denies the booking, the app would get an alert that all the drivers are busy at this moment. I can go back and change my app pickup address. Let's put the airport as the pickup address again, right? And let's say this is a red card, which is good. Let's say book now, accept that, mark the home address again, gets the ride estimate. I apply the promo code again and I keep my Rodeo money. I still use my wallet. I confirm the booking. The driver now decides to accept the trip, right? So now the driver is on the way. So the customer knows exactly how far the driver is. He knows that it's 13-37 minutes away, right? So that's how far the airport is from here. So then let's say the driver says, I've arrived. Okay, we put a check here that the driver has to be in a 2000 meter range around the pick address. Since I am in the same address, this will not work. So let's cancel the booking again. So let the customer cancel this trip. Let's make another booking now from the current address, right? On the current address, we have set up a fixed fee, which will be applied. It's a fixed fee it's an additional fee that one must pay to get picked up from my office. It's in the lines of an airport fee. You know, you would charge a extra, say a surcharge, just for any pickup or drop in the airport. For now, we have set up a app script zone, you know, which is for all pickups from our office here. So let's do a book now. Let's decide to go to the airport rather. Let's do it the other way around. I get the ride estimate. There's no search, so the fare is back to being normal. And I confirm the booking. The driver accepts the booking. I get the confirmation right here. I see the taxi is only 1 minute away. The driver says, I have arrived to pick you up, and the customer gets the alert. Yep. So when the driver is ready, the driver can say begin trip, and the customer would get an alert that the trip has started. So I can go back on the app and I know the trip has started. Let's say I wish to tip the driver. Let's say I want to tip him 5%. So we add the tip. Okay. Now I cannot cancel the booking once the trip is started. That's why the cancel option is, you know, grayed out. On the driver app, we can either navigate using Google Maps, or we've also added the option of using Waze. So let's say if I want to use Google Maps, I can open that on my app and it will show me the way to get to that pickup point with the option of having voice driven directions. Right? So once the trip is complete, I would mark the trip is complete on the driver app. As soon as I do that, the customer would receive an invoice of the you know, what the trip costed, and so since I've used the wallet, it's showing me that I've been charged $0. When I see the receipt, I would see that this is the breakdown. You know, there is a fixed price applied for $20. There is a trip fare of $31. There is a tip. All of that is visible right here. And the due payment is $27.55. Since I have decided to pay for my wallet would be debited with $27.55. So I don't really need to pay any amount to the driver, and that's why it shows up as zero. But on the driver app, it says that $27 is what you earned. I can decide to rate the driver. The driver can decide to rate the customer, and I can also decide to rate the driver in case the service is good. In case the service is poor, I can actually say, you know, I can leave a feedback for the admin that, you know, I did not like the trip. So let's say I like the trip, and let's say I want to submit this review. So the trip would now be complete, and the driver would be visible again for other bookings. The driver can rate the customer as well, and that would be visible to the admin. Now I can go back on my history, right? And I can see this as one of my past bookings. And it shows me the actual path taken. Since my pick and drop was the same, it's not showing me it's showing me two pins rather than the actual path. And I can see the complete receipt right here. Now when I go back on the wallet, it shows me that my wallet has been debited with that amount, 27.55, which is what I had, you know, paid with. So that's reflected on the wallet in real time. And my favorite address is marked as colored, so you know that it's a favorite address. Now on the driver app, I can go back. We have a section we've added called the driver portal. This would actually carry the entire financial breakdown, you know, of whatever the driver has done. So the driver's got two trips today, one cancelled trip, what was the amount he earned, right? We also have added a new option for bonus and guarantees. I know Uber and Ola and Kareem have been infamous for that, and that is how drivers have stuck around for such a long time with these guys, that you can give a bonus in case they kind of, let's say, if the driver does 10 trips in the last, say, from 12 o'clock to 5 o'clock, or his average rating in those 10 trips is above 5 or above 4, the, say, Uber or Ola guarantees them certain amounts, and we've added the function for the same. So you can actually, you know, give the same sorts of service that Ola and Uber are giving to their drivers. And we can even do a guarantee. That is a guaranteed amount which the company would pay the driver in case he's online for, say, 5 hours, and if he's done like 10 trips on that duration. We also know the cash collected amount. That's the cash he's collected in case we are supporting cash bookings. We know exactly how much wallet money is collected. That is 25.95. That is the amount in wallet he's kind of collected. The availability, how long has he been available for bookings? That is also visible here. What is his acceptance rate? It's 75. His rating is 5. His overall rating is 5. And how he could improve his ratings is also shown here. I can go back and check exactly how much I made from different trips. And I can click on that, and that will open my trip details, which again can be clicked to see the breakdown of exactly how much I made. Then I can go back and see how much money I've made in my current cycle. If I had a past cycle, I would also see the history of the past cycle. That's on the driver app, right? So this is something which you've just added, which is great, you know, which is very, very important and very, very nicely done, I would say. That you can maintain payment cycles and pay them by the week, pay them every day, whatever it might be. All that can be configured on the back office. So the payment or the driver portal is a very powerful feature. We have an history option here where the driver can say, okay, how many bookings has he done on different days and how much money he's made. That's added over here. The driver can update his profile. He can see which car he is driving and all of that from the more options here. He can also add his bank details. This is a new feature that we've added. And this is only functional in North America or wherever Stripe allows you to, you know, pay directly to bank accounts. So that those are the only countries that we support. So a driver can add his bank account right here and that would show up. And in case, and we have given the option to the app administrator to directly pay the driver off from the admin panel. So it's a great way to manage all your payroll and financials on the app. So completely managed from the app. So it's a great feature. And we've also added a new feature, which is the manually start trip. So a lot of customers have come and asked us that, you know, a lot of their drivers are traditional taxi companies and they operate as traditional taxi companies. And they, you know, they get hailed at several times. So we have given this option of manually starting a trip. So in case a driver got hailed and he wanted to use the app as a meter, he can simply do that. So he can say, are you sure you want to start a booking? I can say yes. And as soon as that happens, the trip is started, right? And I can enter the drop address right here. I can say I want to go to the airport, right? Let's say, you know, put my local address. Let's say the Mangalore airport. So that would be updated as the drop address. And I can see how much distance I've covered. Now the distance we measure on this app is the actual distance traveled and we do not take the Google distance. The Google distance is only used to generate the estimate, but that is not the actual distance that we use to generate the invoice. So once the drop is complete, the driver can mark the job as complete and he will know exactly how much he needs to collect, right? So this is another cool feature we've added for companies who want to use the app, you know, as a hailing service. So that covers most of the features on the driver app. On the customer app, I guess we can also show you the later feature. So let's schedule a booking for later. And let's say I need a taxi for, say, 9:45, the earliest, I guess. So let's say 9:45. I want to go to the airport. Right? So it gets me the estimate. I confirm the booking. So this booking would be sent to the system. Right? Thanks to the booking. Right? So as soon as the driver is assigned, it'll tell me when I get the driver. So I know the driver is right here right now, so I got it. Let me show you that feature again. A little confusing. Let's make the driver go offline. Let's make him go offline and let's start that later booking process again. Let's say I want a taxi for later and I want it for 9:45. Let's say I want to get to the airport and that's the estimate and I confirm the booking. So the app tells me thanks to the booking we'll get the best possible cab. Now if I go back to the history page, this booking would be shown on the upcoming section. Right? So now I haven't got a driver yet, so I don't know who's going to take my ride. Now let's assume that this driver on the left just got free. So he would go online. So as soon as he goes online, he would get this new request which is in the system. So if he waits around, if he hangs on for a few seconds, the booking which is in the system would be sent out to him. So he would be able to receive this. So let's wait till the system identifies that this driver is now free. In the meanwhile, let's see if we can show you other features on the driver portal. Let's say the details of the cancelled trips can all be seen here. You can go to the current cycle and show you the trips which are made here. So let's see if this comes on. Let's wait till he gets the booking. I know it's turned out to be a really long video, but the app is now so feature rich that it takes quite some time to actually kind of walk you through the entire thing. And we also have a watch app attached to the product, which is something I would love to show you guys. I'll probably make another video for that. So that's another thing which I would love to demo. I guess this covers let's say the major features on the product. There's another feature which I haven't shown, which is the emergency contact. This is again something we have added recently. We can add contacts from our, we can add them as emergency contacts. Let's say I look for my name and I can add my name as an emergency contact. So this is a trip I had scheduled, you know, so that's now confirmed. So if I have an emergency contact, as soon as I make a booking, that contact would get the details of the, you know, would get the details of the trip as soon as I start one. So now when I go back to my request a ride screen, I would see that the trip I had scheduled now found a driver. So now it's working exactly like how it should, you know. It works like a regular booking, and the driver can complete this trip. Let's say I've arrived. I can start the trip. You would notice that the status is changing in real time on the top. So trip complete. So the app is completely real time. It's extremely smooth and easy to use. Let's say I do not like my travel buddy. We've also added a new option where you can actually add Zendesk support. So you can connect your Zendesk account to the app, and the ticket for the trip would be sent to your Zendesk. It's an easier way to manage. That's something we're supporting now. So let's complete the ride. So this pretty much covers all the new features we've added. There's another one I can probably show you, is the pin the drop address on a map. So if I want to select the address from the map, I can even do that. So this is another nice feature we've added for the drop address. It's intuitive for some people to use it this way, so we decided to add it, right? So this pretty much confirms or completes all the, let's say, the more important app side features on the product. We also have a detailed video of the website coming up. We have a web booking system as well. And we also have the watch video coming up next, where you can see how we have integrated the watch. And down the road, we'll also add a video for Siri. So on Apple, we have now hooked up Siri as well. So you can simply order Siri to get you a taxi on Rodeo. So hopefully you guys liked it. It's a long video, I know. Hope you liked it till now, and thank you.